New things are happening, and our good and longtime friend Benny Hebert joins us from the Kevin Cooey Curling Rink, Canadian champions. He has brought the Tankard in with him, Benny, and first of all, I want to say thanks for doing that, and I appreciate you being part of this show. We lined this interview up before we even knew what the show was going to be.
Yeah,
that's crazy.
It's awesome. I mean, done a lot of stuff with you in the past, and you know, a bunch of Q&A's have been around town, and when I saw this come up, you know, I've never actually brought in four times that I've won the Canadian Championship, I've never got to bring the Tankard to Regina. You know, with being in Alberta, it kind of goes there a lot these days for our sponsor things and things we do. And so I spoke this morning at a little work event, and then so I thought, you know what, I'd love to bring it home for both and get it on the show. And yeah, it's nice to have here. I did a little tour with my dad, my uncles, my cousins, my brother. We went out and hit a couple old spots, took it to my high school, so it was fun to have. And special trophy, so glad we could bring it here.
Well, June 13 really snuck up on us because it was like a couple weeks ago. You're like, I'm in Regina, June 13th, let's do it, and here we are. Now, you mentioned the bar tour. Wow. That doesn't look real easy to drink out of, but I'm sure Reginans found a way.
We filled her up. Yeah, we were playing some little gambling bets on how many pints we think we could fit in there. What do you guys think? I know the answer now.
Nine.
Eight pints. We went to Leopold's.
You're talking to.
We went to the North End Leopold's right across from Riffle where I went to school and took it in there with a bunch of my high school buddies. We filled it up. We had 8 pints in there. We had a few sips. We had some good laughs. It was a lot of fun.
You must have needed a crane to like pick it up and like drink it.
My brother, he's excited when I got to bring that. He just hauled it around like it was his. He had a great little night. So it was
Rems,
a lot of fun.
I don't think the viewers, and of course we're on online audio only, I don't think they understand how big this thing actually is. No, I'm not sure it's coming through on the screen. Meat, that's huge.
Yeah, it's big. I was saying, geez, it was going to be real nice to bring a big trophy on here until Bozak and Shortsy won the cup last night. Like, you dirty dogs. So, you know, that's pretty special, though, too, you watching that game last night. And I know Tyler, obviously, from doing a bunch of charity events here in town and, you know, great guy. And I hope that they can bring that one in here. But, you know, this is my Stanley Cup, and this is the best I can. I'm probably not going to win one of those. So this is the best for me. And, you know, pleasure to have it here in Regina.
Something that caught my eye here.
The Richardsons.
As we're sitting here, the Ernie Richardson rink right there is the first one I saw. Kind of puts a lump in my throat. I've got to know Mr. Richardson, Ernie, over the last few years. He's our landlord over at my business. And just, is there a nicer human being in the world than that guy?
No, there isn't, man. He's a legend, an icon in our sport. And, you know, he always gives me the time of day. His brother, Sam, you know, really good friends with my grandpa growing up, too. I used to have beers with him. And Mel Perry, I see on there all the time. And special trophy, you know, it's 93 years old. It's got a lot of history in that baby. So to be on there with those guys, pretty cool.
Well, you know what? You're going to whatever Hall of Fames there are. For sure, the Saskatchewan Sports Hall of Fame, the Canadian Curling Hall of Fame. But I love asking the hockey guys this. Olympic gold or Stanley Cup? I could ask you the exact same thing. Olympic gold or Tankard?
Yeah.
You want them both. What means more?
Yeah, I think I'm going to get myself in trouble. You know, curling these days trending so much towards the Olympics that that's kind of what everybody focuses on. But as a kid for me growing up, like I'm 36 now, I was kind of getting into curling with my dad and things and before the Olympics was kind of alive in curling. And I remember practicing being out there saying, you know, I'll draw the button to win the Brier. You know, double run back to win the Brier. And so the Brier to me, I mean, I've won them both. You win the Stanley Cup, you win the Olympics, I mean, you don't get any more excited or more high than winning that, right? It's the one feeling, you know, elation that you get. I like the Brier just because of the history. I love it. Canadian Championship is the big one. But Olympics, I think, is honestly just more special because it's every 4 years. It's tougher to get to. It's not any easier to win the Brier than it is win the Olympics.
Plus, you won in Canada.
That was special. You know, that was pretty neat. But, you know, I lost in Olympics too, right? It was brutal feeling.
Ooh, so I remember that too.
Oh, just you? That's good. But, I mean, like... There's lots, right? I mean, you go out there. I've played in 10 Briars and won 4. Played in 2 Olympics and won 1. So they're both deadly, and you know they're both amazing. But I don't really know which one I'd pick.
You know, it's funny though. Such a decorated career. You got a long ways to go. Where are you finding motivation aside from a paycheck? You've won it all already. What's driving you these days?
I just had this chat the other day with my dad. I'm like, I don't really like, I don't care about this stuff right now. I don't mentally. Like, someone said, what does it feel like to be on there? I'm like, I can't wait to be on there next year. Like, I want to win, man. Like, I just love winning. I like beating people. I love being the dog. I'm an alpha dog. I want to win. And being on those teams of guys of winning, like, I'm just a crazy winner. Like, I think when I look back and I'm done and we're older and I'm having a beer with John Morris, Mark Kennedy, Kevin Cooey about all the things we won and good times we had on the road and having beers and doing whatever, I mean, that's going to be great. I look forward to those days. I'm just not mentally there yet to even Can's like, I was in the gym this week all week at level 10.
I can tell.
Back. You know, I was home for 2 days. I'm like, can't wait to go see my trainers at level 10. Cranked for 2 days. I'm getting ready for next season. And this stuff's sweet. I mean, hey, celebrate your victories. I was out with my family having a good time having some beers, but I want to win next year. I want to keep it going. So
you're just kind of taking me exactly where I wanted to go with that, with the next question. So maybe this is my perception, but I'd be curious to get your thoughts. When I was a kid watching curling, I don't remember the lead and the second being jacked up and in incredible shape. Now, maybe that's just more impressionable now that I'm an adult, but it seems like in the last, 10 years that, like, especially for the lead and the second that do a lot of the sweeping and the heavy lifting, that you guys are in phenomenal shape.
Yeah, I mean, I'm certainly in a lot better shape now than I was in my early part of it. When you talk about that, I mean, I quit my full-time job and stuff to come home to train. Trained with Ryan Anderson here for a couple summers and Steve Wilson at level 10 full-time. Kind of did that as my gig. Unfortunately, then I got married and had kids, couldn't afford to just swing it with the curling, so I had to go back to work. But, you know, even in Calgary, I worked out at a gym called Crash Conditioning for 3 summers with Jordan Eberle, Thomas Hickey, Zach Boychuk, Mike Green, like some real good guys. I mean, you find some motivation real quick when you're working out. I worked out with Keon Raymond at the gym. That was fun. Try doing sprints with that guy. I mean, there's things you got to do. Things. I mean, curling's changed a little bit. It did change. I mean, I certainly was never in as good a shape as I am probably now. But you have to. Everyone does it. I think it's the same as any sport. It's like, everybody works out. Everybody works hard. People are mentally tough. They got good coaching. They got nutritionists. Those are all just things you got to do to have a chance. If you're missing those things, good luck. Because talent, I mean, the talent can take you over the top if you're doing all the little things. I just find if you're not doing that stuff these days, and there's been years that I haven't done it. And, you know, I found my game kind of slips a little bit. But now, it's, I feel like I work harder now because I have to. As you get older, you know, I was the benchmark for years as a sweeper. You know, I was a big guy, I was strong, I worked out, I made a ton of shots. And I mean, whether it's cocky or not, I don't really give a shit. I still think I'm the benchmark for sweeping. And I don't want to lose that. As soon as you lose that and guys start passing you, you know, that's probably my time. But I mean, I just won the Canadian Championship again. You know, I had a great season, and I continue to try to work hard. I mean, that's what motivates me is I like being there.
Okay, good.
I like being there. I got some buddies that have retired NHL hockey players, curlers. They're like, man, real work sucks. I'm like, dude, I want to curl as long as I
good.
Can.
So that's
where I'm at.
That's a good answer. Yeah. And I called him one time on the air. I called you the Tiger Woods of curling, and you didn't have a problem with it.
Wow.
I think you actually I think it was right
his
when
wife didn't like
his
it.
Wife
no.
put a golf no. club through his windshield around yeah, that yeah, time. Yeah. That's why you took it as a swear word, but I do remember you saying, I don't care if people don't like me because of my attitude, because I got enough friends. I think that was the quote.
Yeah, I mean, it's not, curling's changed too. Like the gentleman sports game of this and that, not making any money and not making a career out of it, it's changed. I mean, we have a huge following now, and you know, with social media, for better or worse, whichever way you want to put it, you know, we're icons in these small rural, like Saskatchewan, Alberta, Manitoba, rural. You know, I'm like Darian Durant used to be around here when you walk into those places, right? I mean, there's certain spots, obviously, currently doesn't matter. You know, the big NHL cities, you know, that's the Raptors, Toronto, there's a lot of action there. But, you know, you got to, it's not shake your hands and drink with your opponents all the time these days. Guys are working hard. There's money to be won, trophies, world championships, Olympic games, there's things out there. I got a wife and kids to support. I mean, yeah, I do have a lot of buddies. And it doesn't matter who you are. You're the nicest guy in the world, someone doesn't like you. You know, and you can't please everybody. So, you know, I compete as an athlete. Like, I played junior football here in Regina. I played provincial lacrosse, baseball. I wouldn't say I come from a curling background, even though, you know, my family did curl growing up. But I have that athlete mentality. And when I first got into the curling scene of, you know, smashed a couple of brooms and kicking rocks, it maybe wasn't taken, you know. But I've been working with my
sports.
You learned
from your Uncle Dave.
Yeah, Uncle Dave, Grandpa Dave. I wouldn't say, this is what I say, I'm not perfect, but I'm getting better, you know, trying to critique it. But I don't want to lose that edge either. You know, you want to keep that, right? And my coach always talked to me about perspective and all this nonsense he makes up to make it okay to lose. I'm like, I like having perspective, but I like having the perfect amount of perspective. I don't want to go too far the other way, because as soon as it's okay to lose, I am gonzo.
Yeah, well, we're going to be doing a ton of curling coverage and talk on this show. And by the way, Braden Muskoe, as soon as he saw you were on here, he's like, I want on here. Michelle Englund's coming on next week. She's got a new team. You probably heard all her news.
Oh, yeah.
So there's a lot of curling talk that we're going to be discussing. But you say you didn't come from a curling background. Well, you've played all sports, and you said you're following the Riders because of John Ryan. Brian more than anything. So maybe you should get into that.
Well, I shouldn't say that. I just, you know, just a little bit disconnected. Obviously, I'm a big Rider fan. I was a season ticket holder here for 15 years. Even when I moved to Calgary, I kept my seats for a few seasons, tried to make it back for a game. But, you know, everything else happens, you know, wife, kids, life, job. I haven't been able to make it home. And I follow, obviously, watch as much as I can on TV. But I played lacrosse against John for a few years and kept in touch with him when he was down in Seattle. And I just, you know, he's one of the best athletes I think Regina's ever seen. You know, he was an amazing lacrosse player. I remember him playing high school football as a running back, you know, university playing as a receiver. He was such a stud. And then you see these guys, you know, and he makes it as a punter. You know, obviously I didn't make the NFL and I'm, you know, a millionaire, all that jazz, but I was good at a lot of other sports that I played, and I ended up kind of making it in curling, which is, you know,
it is about the same as the NFL.
Yeah, close, just a zero. We're probably short a zero or two, maybe, but yeah. It's all good. I mean, I think that's great. I mean, for him to come home and finish his season here, you know, maybe try to win a Grey Cup or two with Regina. I mean, even for me, I'm a Saskatchewan boy through and through. I love this province, and, you know, I owe a lot to the province for being here. And I went to Alberta for this opportunity. You know, taken the ball and run with it, and have done really well. I've had great success, but, you know, you never know what the future holds. And if my team with Kevin Cooey after this next Olympic run, if something came up back home, you know, I'm always open to maybe coming back home and trying to get another gram. I always get jealous at the Brier. Like, I'm slowly transitioning to Alberta guy, but I don't want to lose my Sasky edge. So I you know, see the Saskatchewan, you know, the green and yellow Brier jerseys. I'm like, I'd love to get one of those again, right?
Then come curl here.
Well, no, I'm not good enough. I'm a lead. I'm a role player, right? I'm a third line grinder. I'm power play specialist.
Time to step up, maybe.
So yeah, penalty killer. So I'm on a team with great players, and, you know, if something transitioned to Saskatchewan where I could be a part of that, I'd maybe consider it. But right now I got such a good thing going in Alberta, and, you know, great teammates and a good team. It's, you're not going to walk away from that.
Well, you're a part of a crop, a generation of outstanding Saskatchewan athletes that we're all so proud of. You mentioned your good buddy Eberle, who lives in Calgary in the offseason, right? Yeah. You know, Brett Jones from Weyburn starring with the Vikings, and Graham Dillette still doing some things. So we're all proud to call you a good Sasky boy, too. But how do you deal with the anti-Saskatchewan sentiment of Calgarians? Because I lived there. I went to college there. Dude, it's hard.
It's mostly just the football. Like, I don't get it a
really?
Lot. Yeah, I mean, half the people I work with in Saskatchewan or from Calgary are from Saskatchewan.
Right.
So when you start getting into stamps, riders, I feel a little bit of the hatred or whatever it is. But, you know, real life stuff, I mean, I work in oil and gas, and Alberta's transitioned to Saskatchewan, and they're kind of coming together, a little bit of family here. I don't find it too bad. You know, I find it, you know, it's worse. I'm from Regina, you know, growing up cheering for the Oilers. I grew up in the 80s. You know, I love Gretzky. I love that story. Didn't really have a team. I cheered for the Pats. The Pats were my team, right? Louis Dumont, like those guys. Those were my team, you know? Russ Gronick. Remember Russ Gronick, the fighter?
Absolutely, yeah.
He was buddies with one of my cousins, so I remember cheering for him. Like, my buddy Jordan.
He works at the Brand Center now.
You know, Garth Murray, I played hockey with my whole life. You know, he's right. Cheered for the Pats. That was my team. So moving up there to Calgary, I host. I do some client stuff. You go to Flames games, and everyone in Calgary hates the Oilers. Oilers hate the Flames. Like, who do you cheer for? I'm like, kind of like both. I like both teams. Hope they both
do well.
And
they're like, how can you do that?
Yeah, I'm a traitor, and I'm like, you got. I'm a hockey fan. Like, I like watching good hockey. They're both.
No, they're. You got to pick one.
Yeah,
they're saying.
You know, yeah. So I don't find the Saskatchewan Calgary hate too much. I mean, maybe it's out there. I know it's alive and well when, you know, me and Ebs have gone to a couple Stamps games in Calgary in our Rider gear, and, you know, you get heckled a bit. But I mean, those games are half Rider fans, anyways.
Yeah.
I don't go to any other Stamps games. Oops. So there you go.
You know, real quick story. I was visiting my uncle in Edmonton, and I had my Rider jersey on because I was going to the game that night. This is about 2 years ago. Neighbor across the street at my uncle's cul-de-sac in Edmonton yells, "Riders suck!" And I didn't think too much about it. I just kind of gave him a thumbs up. But then about 18 seconds later, another guy comes out and he goes, "Go, Riders, go! Go, Riders, go!" And I realized that they're having fun with it, though. Like, it's not
well,
like...
some do.
Yeah, but,
not all.
But I mean, half yeah. the... You're right. I agree with what you're saying. There's probably an honest 30 to 40% of people that live in those two cities probably are from Saskatchewan.
Don't they say, Benny, it's a third of Calgary's Saskatchewan roots?
Seems
have you
like
heard
it's
that?
A lot. I mean, everywhere you go, oh, where are you from? I'm from Saskatchewan. Oh, me too. Oh, I grew up there. My parents grew up there. And yeah, it's a pretty, you know, a lot of people now. I mean, I've lived there for 8 years. I mean, I have a career there, curling there. Like, I would much prefer Regina. Sorry to all my Calgarian peeps, but I love the small town. I like people. Like, last night, I'm staying at the Sask Hotel. Drive to play men's night at the Royal Regina, 6 minutes away. Back to my hotel, change Vicks, cross street. Like, you don't get to do that in Calgary. You got to plan something in Calgary. It's got to be a 3-week planned vacation
to drive,
to go somewhere, and then have a babysitter and an Uber. It's just like, it's just so easy here.
Yeah.
You know, people don't get that, the big city hustle bustle. I mean, hey, I live that life. That's not me.
Toronto's worse than that.
Oh, yeah. I've been there a million times for curling. So I like Regina. I like the city, the size. And they could maybe work on the construction right now. But other than that, we're doing okay.
Well, there's no snow. So we got to build the roads when there's no snow.
One in 10
of our viewers of this show is from Alberta, by the way. And Calgary area specifically. So I don't know if that's Saskatchewan people that, or if they're Stamps fans that are dying for. Yeah, probably. Yeah, all my Stamps friends.
Yeah.
All two of them.
Yeah.
But I don't know what it is. We have a heavy Alberta contingent there, but it's funny because this morning I was jumping into my car outside the studio here, and it says your drive home is 15 minutes, and I broke out laughing. I'm like, from anywhere it would say 15 minutes, anywhere. Even this is the furthest. I live on Gordon Road, meet.
Yeah,
so
yeah,
think not, where we
well,
are.
It is though. It's 15 minutes
to anywhere.
It's perfect.
So it is perfect. Yeah. So just before we let you go, Benny Hebert, a shot on when your season starts. What's coming up for the Koe team, and what's up between now and then for you?
Yeah, I mean, well, no ice. We got no ice in the summer, which is great. So we get a nice little break, heal up a little bit, some injuries and stuff, and just get back in the gym, train. A lot of sponsor stuff this summer to take care of. We know we got this baby, this TANKARD, we're going to haul around and
good
do a bunch
you.
Of events. We're shooting a commercial on Monday with Canadian Beef out on some farm in Didsbury. We're going to do some stuff with the farm. We got some stuff with ATB Financial. We're doing UFA, Caltech Surveys, all our sponsors. We got a bunch of stuff going on. Get ready for the season. Season's long now these days. It's not a short little Friday to Monday stints we don't have anymore, right? Or 6-7 day events, and we start up in September. Same thing, just like the golf tour, right? There's a whole bunch of events. You pick and choose which ones you want to go to, and then we don't have to play provincials next year. We're Team Canada, so we get to go straight back to the Brier, which is a beautiful thing. So we got a
nice amendment there, right?
Nice amendment there. Yeah. So we got a nice little February off just to kind of prep and get ready. I mean, that's the big one next year. Olympic trials points starts again next year, which is crazy to think about that already. But, I mean, our goal is going to be to get our hands back on this baby and defend as Team Canada, and that's in Kingston, Ontario, home of the hip.
And a lot of things.
Right?
And Don Cherry and Doug Gilmore and Rob Bagg and a lot of guys.
So that's it for me. Maybe get caught up on my rider chat. See if I can name five of the guys for the next time I come in here.
Just watch the game tonight.
Yeah, well, the Raptors are on tonight.
Yeah, that too.
I saw your poll. Yeah. I'm Raptors tonight.
You're more excited for the Raptors?
Oh, yeah.
A lot of people
me
are.
Me too.
Benny, keep making us proud as you are, and I'm glad the fire still burns.
Oh,
and thanks for bringing the trophy in.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
All right, Benny Hebert, our own.
You're watching Rod Pedersen On Demand. For more of The Rod Pedersen Show, visit rodpedersen.com or follow Rod Pedersen on social media.